It was all a lie. Makros sold us a vision he never believed in. He would destroy us. We just didn't know it yet. We were warriors, but he turned us against each other. Brother against brother. And despite all the maneuvers and all the strategy, in the end, it was going to be either me or him. Makros was the better warrior that day. He left me for dead, but I survived. Makros thinks the war is over, but our fight has just begun.
This won't be easy. They've got 1,000 men in there defending her.
If anyone can get in there, Orin can.
You understand how important this mission is. The weapon we need is inside this temple.
Sir!
You can count on us.
You two cover the back. I'll take the front.
Is your armor holding up?
It's sluggish.
Sir, you're still injured.
Doesn't matter. We have a job to do.
She won't want to leave the temple, Oren.
I know. I'm approaching the entrance. Won't be long now.
Good luck, Orin.
Temple of the Seventh Sanctum.
Hello, Orin. I knew I'd see you again someday.
And you know why I'm here.
The monolith is a weapon like no other. It has the power to reshape reality. And your brother controls it.
For now.
He nearly has the power of the god. And you are one man. An injured man at that.
I didn't come here for your encouragement, Sanctum.
Are greatly against you. And I am not just some tool at your disposal, Auron.
We will discuss this when I get there.
How could you possibly defeat your brother and all his forces? Tell me.
I'll find a way. I just need to get inside the monolith.
did you expect me to react, Auron?
I have a duty to stop him.
Macro succeeds.
He becomes a god, and the world as we know it will end.
I fear you may be right. Your odds are 1,000 to 1. But I'll help you. On one condition.
What is it?
You won't like it, Auron.
Well done, Auron. Welcome.
I am here, Sanctum. Tell me what you need.
Makros nearly has the power of a god. If you are to defeat him, your plan must be flawless. And I can craft such a plan.
I trusted Makros once. Now you're asking me to trust you.
It will only be until Makros is vanquished. You will see.
Even if I don't agree.
You came to me because you saw no other way. This is your path. Let me guide you.
Do not betray me, Sanctum. Too much is at stake.
May the Archon of Rebirth watch over you. We are heading into the monolith. Once inside, we won't be coming out until Macross is finished. We will arrive in the Earth Realm, the lowest level of the monolith interior. Macross has learned how he can use the monolith to become a god. It is an ancient spell, the Rites of Ascension. This spell can be broken, but only if we know it ourselves. A copy of the Rites of Ascension are stored here, in the Earth Realm, guarded by Macross' men. You must go to their base and seize the rites for yourself. Bring them to me, and I will find a way to break the spell. This is the Earth Realm, where our adventure begins.
Point me towards this watchtower.
I'll guide you on your path, but keep your sword close. You'll find me. Twilight beacons mark places where we can start future missions. Let's activate as many of these as we can. lost Valorian artifacts will help you grow stronger. The watchtower is up ahead. Keep your hand on your sword. Is on the upper level of the watchtower.
I'm here for the rites of ascension.
Raise your sword!
But he hasn't gone far. Track his men. They'll lead you to him.
Thank you.
Hand it over if you want to live.
This is for Macross alone.
Macross has gone mad.
Well done. We have the rites of ascension. I'll study this spell and learn its secrets. But I cannot fight Makros and his army. That job is yours, and yours alone. Are you ready to see what you are up against?
Show me my enemies. Makros. He's not a god yet. Tell me how the rites of ascension work.
In order to complete the rites, Makros will need to absorb a massive amount of Aetherium.
I doubt he's gathering all of that energy on his own.
Exactly. Each of his lieutenants is channeling elemental energies for him.
They'll be his strongest allies.
Without a doubt. But remember, when you defeat them, their strength will become your own. This is Zamora the Farseer. Her Vargul warriors hold the Earth Realm for Makros.
She's a powerful sorcerer.
She's an animal, fighting to survive. She's sealed herself in her lair behind the prismatic falls. You'll have to find a way to breach her defenses. Next, you'll face Lunara. It's in the Water Realm, drawing magical energy from beneath the surface.
Lunara is a guardian construct. It won't be easy.
Lunara is mindless, but still dangerous. Unfortunately, its participation in the rites has only made it more powerful.
I recognize this one. Greaves Sunsteel.
Greaves is a godsmith and a madman. He is responsible for arming most of Makros' elite warriors.
He is also a master of fire magic.
He only serves Makros because it benefits himself. Lastly, Gildan Commander, a true believer in Makros' right to become a god. He holds court in the Air Realm, forcing trials of combat on unwilling souls.
I don't know this one.
Makros sees him as your replacement.
Killing his lieutenants isn't enough. I have to face him.
Makros absorbs the Aetherium they send him. He believes he is already unstoppable.
He's wrong. I'll stop him.
You are strong, Auron, but not strong enough to defeat Makros and all of his men. You must train. I've found a man who can help. He is a godsmith of some renown who can help you craft and upgrade your gear. The Vargul are holding him captive on the other side of the Crimson Glades. Head to the Vargul stronghold breach their defenses, and rescue this godsmith. strangers are not well liked by the Vargul, you least of all. They will attack you on sight. Totems are full of magic. Smash them, and that magic can be yours.
Thank you.
is part of my training.
You are always training, Auron. There's an Ethereum seal over the fortress gate.
Tell me our options.
I can shatter these magical barriers if we are able to gather enough power. Head to the base of the Prismatic Falls. There is a source of rich Aetherium there we can use.
You see what I see.
I am housed within your valor plate. I can affect the world through you.
Thank you.
The Godsmith is in the cavern behind the fortress.
He'll be glad to see us.
Thank you.
He's back through there.
Thank the Archons. I thought I'd be stuck here. Wait.
Orin?
You're alive!
Xenon, I didn't know it was you here.
And I didn't know you were still alive. I'll take this as a sign. Perhaps we'll survive Macross's madness after all.
Come, we have much to discuss.
Are we going into a sanctum? Oh, Orin.
So this is the inside of a sanctum.
She's quite something. Though, I did not expect her to be so independent.
She's a living being, Auron. Not merely some weapon to be wielded.
Well, in that case, I'll have to look to you for the weapons.
Ha! You never change. I'll provide you with basic arms. The rest we can forge. Here, this will help.
A sacred flame.
Go on. Light the forge with it.
Your equipment once we gather the right materials.
It's good you found Zenon. He'll be useful.
He's also a friend of yours.
We're at war. You and I only have time for those we find useful.
Perhaps. Usefulness comes after care, Auron.
What I care about is defeating Makros. If Zenon can help us do that, so much the better.
From an Earth sigil we acquired at the Vargal Fortress, I've been able to locate Zamora the Farseeing. Valorians who value physical strength look to Bulwark for inspiration.